Today we'll show how to reverse the hinging on your Continental solid door one section refrigerator or freezer. Before doing this, it's always recommended to disconnect the power to the cabinet.
The following tools will be needed to do this: a small Phillips and slotted screwdriver, standard Phillips screwdriver, a putty knife, electrical tape, a wire cutter and crimping tool, needle nose pliers, 2 1/4-inch female connectors, and 2 5/16 female connectors. Not all single section cases are able to be rehinged, and to confirm, you can contact the factory with the model and serial number. Another way you can tell is if there's an extra set of hinge and lock keeper holes on the opposite side, as well as a stainless steel plug button. Open the door 90 degrees and lift up and out of the hinges and set the door to the side. With a standard Phillips screwdriver, remove the top and bottom hinges and make sure that you slide the light switch out of the body of the top hinge. Remove the 2 Phillips screws on the inside of the lock keeper and then the 2 Phillips screws that mount the keeper to the front of the case and set these to the side. At Continental, we're always looking to improve our design, and you may have a case with our current design with the light switch in the body of the top hinge, or on older cases, the light switch is in the face of the cabinet with an actuator pin in the body of the hinge. Remove the 2 wire connectors on the body of the switch and cut the connectors off, tape the ends, and remove the black plastic snap bushing from the front of the cabinet and push the brown wire back into the hole at the face of the case. Remove the Phillips screws for the hinges and lock keeper, as well as the stainless steel plug button from the opposite side, and remount into the original mounting holes. Once the stainless steel plug button is removed, take the needle nose pliers and remove the black lamp cord wire that's in the hole. Carefully strip the ends of the black lamp cord wire. Using the crimping tool, install the 2 1/4-inch female connectors onto the ends of the black wires, making sure the connections are tight. Once the connectors are installed, take the original light switch and push the 2 connectors back onto the back of the switch. You will notice a slot in the plastic hinge bushings in the top and bottom hinges. Take a small slotted screwdriver and lift the hinge bushing out of the body of the hinge, spin it to the opposite direction, and reinsert it into the hinges, making sure that it is set properly. Install the top and bottom hinges using the flathead Phillips screws. Slide the hinge covers off the door hinges and remove the Phillips mounting screws, and reverse the hinges, and then reinstall the Phillips screws to the side of the door. After this is done, reinstall the hinge covers back onto the door. You may have to remove the front grille depending on ceiling height. If so, disconnect the connectors on the back of the electronic control, and it is always recommended to note the location of these connections to be sure that they are reconnected properly. Loosen the 4 Phillips screws on the back corners of the grille and carefully lift the grill up and out of the keyhole slots and set to the side. Using a small slotted screwdriver, remove the 3 mounting screws for the control box cover and set the cover to the side. Inside the control box, you should see a tag mounted to the black lamp cord wire giving instructions on how to do the reverse wiring for this hinge switch. Strip the ends of the black lamp cord wire and install the 2 5/16 female connectors, making sure that they are crimped properly. Remove the 2 brown wires from the terminal block feeding power to the original light switch and tape the ends and set the wire back into the control box. Take the 2 black wires and remount to the terminal block in the position that the brown wires were connected originally. Remount the front grille, making sure that the 4 Phillips mounting screws are tight, as well as the connectors on the back of the electronic control, making sure that they are pushed in properly, and then remount the control box cover. Restore power to the cabinet and remount the door, making sure that it closes properly. Open and close the door a few times, making sure that the light goes off and on as the door is closed and opened. After this is done, make sure that the door gaskets are sealing properly on all four sides, as well as the lock keeper is adjusted properly and the door is able to be locked and unlocked. For additional information, visit our website at www.continentalrefrigerator.com.